looking at this problem, in the first place, I have to raise the product. The product can be raised by multiplying the first number, which is 2, multiplied by negative 3. I'm sure that is understood. The whatever can be there, this time it is a 2 before x squared. The coefficient of x squared is 2 multiplied by the last number. So this is 2 multiplied by negative 3. And that way the product is going to be raised. So I say product. The product, 2 multiplied by negative 3, this is negative 6. Then the next thing is to raise the sum. The number in between, this is a D, which is a negative 5. So you have to consider a negative 5. It's not always that a sum is going to be a negative throughout. In some questions, you find that the sum is going to be given to be positive. Then three factors. Or let me say number factors. So these factors must be raised in pairs. First of all, I have to explain what it means by a factor. A factor is a number that divides into another number without leaving any remainder. I'm sure that is understood. And again, in maths, it can be convenient that those numbers that can be multiplied to get the product qualify to be factors. So if you have a product which is 10, then you can multiply 1 by 10 to get 10. So 1 and 10 qualify to be factors. You can multiply 2 by 5 to get 10. So 2 and 5 qualify also to be the factors of 10. In the same manner, when you look at the product there, the product is 6, which is a negative, and the sum is a negative 5. Then what can be the factors of negative 6? So to raise the factors of negative 6, first of all, raise the factors of positive 6. These are 1 multiplied by 6, followed by 2 multiplied by 3. So these are the factors of 6. But you have to be fair that this 6 is negative, and the sum is also negative. First of all, make bigger numbers to be negatives, like that. So that if you can multiply 1 multiplied by negative 6, this is the product negative 6. 2 multiplied by negative 3, this is the negative 6. I'm sure that is understood. Now, try to check the factors which you have raised. Where can you add the 2 factors so that you get the number in between there, which is negative 5? And this is what is said to be the sum. So if you look at positive 1, negative 6, and the answer is going to be negative 5. So positive 1 and negative 6, the answer is positive 5. But positive 2 and negative 3, the answer is going to be negative 1. So the correct factors are these, which is of which this is positive 1 and negative 6. Now, if you look at this problem, you have x squared and the x there. Then this one is going to become positive 1x. I'm sure that is understood. Positive x, and this negative 6 becomes negative 6x. I'm sure that is seen. Now, after that, what you have to do is that you have to copy the question, which is 2x squared minus 5x, then minus 3 equals 0. Upon the copying the question that way, then what you are going to do is that these factors which you have raised, positive x and negative 6, is going to be substituted in place of negative 5. So in the next stage, negative 5 is not going to be shown, but the factors which you have chosen. I'm sure that is understood. So this is now 2x squared. Then you have found the factors to be positive x and negative 6. So this is positive x and negative 6 x. I'm sure if you can add the positive x, negative 6x, then you get negative 5. Then you have to maintain that. There is a minus 3 there. You maintain minus 3. And this is equals, and that is equals 0. I'm sure that is seen. Smartly like that, this statement must be repeated. I'm going to repeat this statement for a reason. One may wonder to say, why is this man repeating this statement? So I repeat the statement. This is 2x squared plus x minus 6x minus 3, and this is equals 0. Upon repeating this statement, then these must be enclosed in brackets. 1, 2 in brackets like that. Again, 1, 2 in brackets like that. I'm sure that is seen. Now, by introducing the brackets, then even if this statement and that statement were the same, they are now different because this one is carrying the brackets, whereas the other one is not carrying the brackets. I'm sure that is observed. Then from there, it is at this point that you are going to factor what is in the first two brackets, open and close bracket, open and close bracket. In the first two brackets, you have 2x squared plus x. In the second, you have negative 6x minus 3. So you have to make sure that you remove that which is common. So looking at 2x squared plus x, x is common. So if I happen to remove x outside the brackets, x into 2x squared, I get 2x like that. So if I multiply x multiplied by 2x, I get back to 2x squared. Then x into positive x, I get positive 1. I'm sure that is seen, and this is enclosed in brackets. Then looking at this, this is a negative 6 and x and negative 3. Mind you, there is a number that can go into 6 and a 3. That is a 3. 3 can go into negative 6 and 3 can go into 3. And again, we have a negative. So a negative 3 is going to be removed outside the brackets. I remove a negative 3 so that this negative 3 into negative 6x, I get positive 2x. I'm sure that is seen. Then negative 3 into negative 3, I get positive 1. Then in brackets, after that, this is equals 0. I'm sure that can be observed. So without wasting much of your time, since I'm solving this problem by using factors, then I have to factorize completely. Factorizing completely means that you have to bring in the two brackets like that, then equals 0, so that you can use what we can term as zero product property. Whatever is in this bracket multiplied by that bracket equals 0, then this is what is said to be the zero product property. Then what you have to do there is that in this inside the brackets, it can be seen that this is 2x plus 1 and that this is 2x plus 1. And this is the clear indication that I am moving in a right channel. So now, outside the bracket, you have x and minus 3. So you collect x minus 3 in one of the two brackets. So this is x minus 3. And those which are common, 2x plus 1, 2x plus 1, to be collected in the other bracket, 2x plus 1. I'm sure that is seen. So this is not all that difficult, but simple and straightforward. Driving it further, it can be driven further as follows.